Alright, this is the Lewis dot for phosphorus trichloride. First thing you do is add up the valence electrons, and you have phosphorus with 5, and 3 chlorines each with 7. Alright, that's 21 plus 5 is 26 valence electrons. Next step, you're going to draw the skeleton of this molecule. So you put your phosphorus surrounded by 3 chlorines. Alright, and you connect them with a bond. The bond is equivalent to 2 valence electrons. Alright, then starting with the outer atoms, which are the chlorines, you're going to put in pairs up to 8. Now, since the bond already counts as 2, alright, we can just add another 6 dots. That would be 8. So far, we have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, and 26. To check the molecule, we're going to go for the octet rule and see if this follows it. We got 2 electrons here as a bond, and another 6 lone pairs, so that's 8. And then we look at phosphorus, 2, 4, 6, and the lone pair is 8. For those of you that have to do hybridization, all you do is count the pairs around the central atom, and you go 2, 4, 6, 8. So that's 4 pairs, so we need 4 orbitals. So we take an S, and we take 3 P's, and you have an sp3 hybridized orbital. Now, if you need the shape, well, we got to start with the general formula, which is AX3E. The A is the central atom, the X are the 3 chlorines, and the E is the lone pair on top of the phosphorus. This gives you a trigonal pyramidal shape. Trigonal pyramid. Alright, and the bond angle, since it's a lone pair, the bond angle for the parent shape, which is the tetrahedral, if all 4 sites were bonded, is 109.5. However, because it has 1 lone pair, you take away 2.5, and you have a 107 degree bond angle. And that's it. That's the little structure for phosphorus trichloride.